bacterial infection that usually affects the mucous membranes of your nose and throat. Diphtheria is extremely rare in the United States and other developed countries, thanks to widespread vaccinations against the disease. It can be treated with medications, but in advanced stages, diphtheria can damage your heart, kidneys, and nervous system. Even with treatment, diphtheria can be deadly, especially in children. Diphtheria signs and symptoms usually begin 2 to 5 days after a person becomes infected, and it may include a thick gray membrane covering your throat and tonsils, a sore throat and hoarseness, swollen glands in your neck, difficulty breathing or rapid breathing, nasal discharge, fever and chills, and malaise. Diphtheria is caused by a bacterium, Corynebacterium diphtheriae. The bacterium usually multiplies on or near the surface of the throat. C. diphtheriae spreads via airborne droplets and contaminated personal or household items. When an infected person sneezes or cough releases a mist of contaminated droplets, people nearby may inhale C. diphtheriae. Diphtheria spreads easily this way, especially in crowded conditions. People occasionally catch diphtheria from handling or an infected person's things, such as used tissues or hand towels, that may be contaminated with the bacteria. You can also transfer diphtheria-causing bacteria by touching an infected wound. People who are at an increased risk of contracting diphtheria include children and adults who don't have up-to-date vaccinations, people living in crowded or unsanitary conditions, and anyone who travels to an area where diphtheria infections are more common. Diphtheria rarely occurs in the U.S. and Western Europe, where children have been vaccinated against the condition for decades. However, diphtheria is still common in developing countries where vaccination rates are low. For the diagnosis, your doctor will likely perform a physical exam to check for any swollen lymph nodes. They'll also ask you about your medical history and the symptoms you have been experiencing. They can also take a swab the back of the throat or nose to test for the bacteria that causes diphtheria. For treatment, diphtheria is a serious illness, and so doctors are going to treat it immediately and aggressively. Treatments include antibiotics such as penicillin or erythromycin, which help kill the bacteria in the body, clearing up infections. Antibiotics cut the time that someone with diphtheria If a doctor suspects diphtheria, they will request a medication that counteracts the diphtheria toxin in the body. This medication is called antitoxin, and this drug is injected into a vein or muscle. Before giving this antitoxin, doctors may perform skin allergy tests. These are done to make sure that the infected person does not have an allergic reaction to the antitoxin. If someone is allergic, the doctor will need to desensitize them to the antitoxin, so they will begin by giving small doses for the antitoxin and then gradually increase the dose. There are also preventative treatments such as booster doses of the diphtheria vaccine. For prevention, the diphtheria vaccine is usually combined with vaccines for tetanus, pertussis, also known as whooping cough. And the 3-in-1 vaccine is known as the diphtheria, tetanus, and pertussis vaccine. The latest version of this vaccine is known as the DTaP vaccine for children and the Tdap vaccine for adolescents and adults. The diphtheria, tetanus, and pertussis vaccine is one of the childhood immunizations that doctors in the U.S. recommend during infancy. Vaccination consists of a series of 5 shots, typically administered in the arm or thigh, given to children at 2 months, 4 months, 6 months, 15 to 18 months, and 4 to 6 years old. And after the initial series of immunizations in childhood, they'll need to receive booster shots of the diphtheria vaccine to help maintain their immunity, because immunity to diphtheria fades with time. The prognosis of diphtheria ranges from good to poor, depending on how early the infection the patient is treated, how early in the infection the patient is treated, and how the patient responds to treatments. If the patient develops sepsis or a bacterium, or if there's cardiac involvement, the prognosis is usually poor. The mortality rate is highest in patients less than 5 years old and in the patients that are older than 40. The average rate of death from diphtheria is about 5 to 10%. These are my sources if you have any.